Wind-fueled flames race across Angel Island in San Francisco's Bay. Campers are evacuated as fire crews try to save some historic buildings. Good afternoon. I'm Adrienne Bankert. Fire crews dealing with rugged terrain and erratic winds. The fire started last night on the eastern part of Angel Island and quickly spread. This island is a popular destination for hikers and campers. It's a short ferry ride from Tiburon, and that is where KCRA3's Sharakina Shams is live with the latest. Sharakina.
Adrienne, 40 campers evacuated from Angel Island last night. Over the past couple of hours alone, 200 additional firefighters, including some inmate crews you're about to see, have arrived here to help fight these flames. Now, as we take a closer look at the smoke at Angel Island, I can tell you I just spoke with Marin County Fire Chief Mike Giannini. He tells us they are still investigating the cause of this fire, but one thing they're looking at is possibly a bonfire last night that may have gotten out of control. Now we're going to show you what the fire looks like in a second, but first, take a look at the effort it takes here just to get to the flames. Some relief came this morning at daylight when finally aircraft could fly and fight these flames by air. They couldn't do that last night when the fire broke out at about 9 p.m. At least there's a water source here, right? Firefighters scooping up the waters of the bay to drop over the flames, also using fire retardant from above. The aircraft sent in this morning by Cal Fire. Still, just as they can use the bay's resources to their advantage, it can also be a disadvantage. This landscape is a hindrance because inmate crews had to gather here at Tiburon, then get aboard a ferry to make it to the island, meaning if you're going to fight this fire on the ground, it takes some time to get into position. The fire was fueled last night by a north wind that spread it across the northern edge of the island, and it has grown outward on all its edges, so it's now burning in the direct center of Angel Island. Coming back out here live, again, there is some concern to historic buildings on the east side of Angel Island. That's in the area of East Garrison. But as firefighters work to protect that area, I can tell you the good news out here, no injuries to talk about. A lot of people, though, startled. You took a look there at what some of the flames have looked like in the nighttime hours. That's visible both from here, Tiburon, and San Francisco to the south. I'm Sharakina Shams reporting live from Marin County. Adrienne, back to you in the studio.
All right, Sharakina, thank you so much. And we're going to actually take a look at where Sharakina is now. We're just a little ways away from her. This is an aerial shot from Angel Island. You can see the damage this fire has done. Dry brush, trees blackened. And this island's a popular area for hikers with its tree-lined paths and sweeping views of San Francisco and the Golden Gate. And Angel Island is also rich in history. It's been called the Ellis Island of the West. An immigration station from the early 1900s is still standing there. Approximately 1 million immigrants were processed at Angel Island, and that station has been designated as a National Historic Landmark. The island also housed a military base during the Civil War and World War II.